Now, the next time identity I am going to explain you about is x plus y plus z. Now, what I have done, I have taken three terms. Till now, we have seen for only two terms, squaring and cubing. Okay. Now, I have taken three terms, x plus y plus z, whole square I am going to do now. Okay, students. Means what? X plus y plus z whole square means what, students? X plus y plus z into x plus y plus z. See, x plus y plus z is multiplied two times. Okay. Now, what we have to do? So, multiply this x with all these terms. Multiply y with all these terms. And multiply this z with all these terms. So let us do one by one slowly. Don't be in a hurry, students. Just do slowly. X into x gives x square plus x into plus y gives plus xy plus x into plus z gives plus xz. Okay. Now x term is over. Now multiply y term plus y into plus x is plus yx plus y into plus y is plus y square plus y into plus z is plus yz. Now y term is over, students. Now next multiply with z. Plus z into plus x is plus zx plus z into plus y is plus zy plus z into plus z is plus z square. Now, observe the like terms. Observe the like terms. Okay. What are the like terms here? See, here one xy is there. And here one xy is there. So, y into x or x into y, both are same, students. So, first I am going to write all the square terms. That is x square plus y square plus z square. Now, observe the like terms, students. See, here one xy is there, one xy is there. How many xy's? Total two xy's are there here. And again one yz is there, another yz is there. Two yz's are there here. And the next like term is xz and zx. Both are same. Plus two zx are there. So the formula for x plus y plus z whole square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. Is it clear, students? Now, the next one I am going to explain you is x plus a into x plus b. Look here, students. See, the first term is x and the second term is a. This is a constant. This is not a variable here. Okay, this is a constant. This is not a variable. Okay, a and b are constants here. So, how to do this sum? Just multiply, apply distributivity. So, x into b and this term with all these two terms. So, let us do, students, x into x cubes, x square, x into b gives plus xb plus a into x gives plus a into x and plus a into b gives plus ab. Okay, see here x square plus, see in these two terms, what is a common thing here? X is common thing. So a plus b I am writing. Just I have shifted these two terms. That's all, no problem. Plus a into b. This is the formula. So, the formula is x plus a into x plus b can be written as x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. Okay, student. The next identity I am going to take here is x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. So, we are going to find the value for this, students. Okay. As usual, apply distributive property here. Multiply this x with all these terms. Multiply y with all these terms. And multiply z with all these terms. So place will not be sufficient here. I'm going to write from here, students. Don't get confused. So we will get x into x square as x cube plus x into plus y square as plus x y square plus x into plus z square as plus x z square. Okay. Now plus x into minus x y minus x square y plus y into minus y z minus x y z plus x into minus z x minus x square z. Okay. We have multiplied x with all these terms. Now I am going to multiply y with all these terms. Here place will not be sufficient. It will be a lengthy sentence. So I am writing here continuation. Plus y into plus x square is plus y x square. Plus y into plus y square is plus y cube. Plus y into plus z square is plus y z square. Plus y into minus x y is minus x y square plus y into minus y z is minus y square z plus y into minus z x is minus x y z. So with y over, and now I am going to multiply all these terms with z term. Okay students, now multiplying z with x square gives plus z x square plus z y square plus z cube minus zxy minus yz square minus z square x. No, so this is the full sentence. Okay students, now observe here the like terms. Observe all the like terms students. First I am going to write all the cube terms. What are all the cube terms? X cube plus y cube plus z cube. Okay students, the like terms are x, z square. So, c to the power x, 1 is there, to the power z, 2 is there. So, identify the like term here, x, z square. See here, x, z square. C plus x, z square minus x, z square becomes 0 and this gets cancelled out, okay? Now, minus x square y. So, identify x square y like term. Is there any like term for this? X square y. Yes, here it is. So, minus x square y plus x square y becomes 0. Cancel it out. Minus x y z. Here minus x y z is there. And here also minus x y z is there. Z x y or x y z, both are same students. So, how many are there? Total 3 are there. So, minus 3xyz. This is over. Okay, next x square z term. Observe the x square z term. X square z. Where it is? Yes, here it is. Plus x square z. And here minus is there. So, one positive, one negative gets cancelled out, students. Next y cube we have written here. Next we have y z square. Observe where is this like term here? Y z square. Okay, y z square. Yes, positive and negative gets cancelled out. Minus x y square. Where is another x y square? Here it is. So plus x y square and minus x y square gets cancelled out, students. This value becomes 0. That's why I am cancelling. Okay. Next we have minus y square z. Another y square z is here. Plus y square z and minus y square z becomes 0. It value becomes 0. Cancel it out. Minus x y z we have calculated. That is over. Z cube we have written here. And this is also calculated. See, all terms are finished. So we got the answer as x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. Okay students, so the formula is x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx gives what? X cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. Okay students, So in this way, we can derive all the formulas, all the algebraic identities. Is it clear, students? So what is the thing we have to know here? Property. The main property we applied here is distributive property. Is it clear, students? We have to know the distributive property for obtaining all these algebraic identities. So this is all about deriving algebraic identities, students. If you really understand about all these derivations, please share and subscribe. Thank you for watching my video.